You ever someone tell you look like somebody? Never leads to good stuff, does it? Somebody goes, you look like my friend. Then you meet the friend, you're like, holy fuck. That's what I look like, kill me now. One girl once told me, it's a true story, maybe. She goes, you look like John Goodman. I was like, what? She goes, no, a young, thin John Goodman. Like, that's gonna make me feel better. That's like if I said to a girl, which I wouldn't, you look like a pig, yeah. Oh, no, not a fat pig, no. You thought I meant a fat pig. No, a young, thin pig. Like a hot, smoking pig. Yeah, like with a pretty bow in its hair. You thought I meant fat pig. No wonder you looked depressed when I said it. No, a hot fucking pig. Like Lonnie Anderson, but less piggy and more the things. Huh? I didn't really finish that joke. Remember it used to be you took a picture of someone? Jimmy Pardo, ladies and gentlemen. You know what sucks about that? When someone walks behind you, you think your joke got a better laugh. You're like, oh, they like that. And you're like, oh, they didn't. Getting all cocky, fixing my collar. You know what I mean? And that was Bill Cosby. Okay. Oh. So, used to be you took pictures and you never saw them. You know, someone would say, hey, remember we went skiing 10 years ago? I got those pictures. Now with digital cameras, it's like, let me see it. No, let me see it. Come on. Let me see it means let me see how fucking fat I look. Let me see if you're gonna delete it. No, delete it. Come on. Every picture I look like, I feel I look like this. Wanna take a picture of me? Get up on a ladder. All right, there you go. All right. Ever have people show you pictures you're not in? They go, oh, we went skiing, look at our pictures. I'm not in them? You're like, okay, there you go. Oh yeah, that's a lot of fun. I really wanna look at pictures without me in them. That's fucking all I have to do all day. That doesn't sound very nice, but it's, you know. Everything I say right up here, it's right out of the newspaper today. Everything's topical. You know in LA they have to grade the restaurants? If you go to a restaurant in the window, the health department, you have to put an A, a B, a C, or a D, right? So I went to a restaurant the other day, it had a D in the window. And next to it, the owner of the restaurant wrote Alicious. That's fucked up. You can't. You can't. Sir, what if he works for the health department and he left? Can't do that. That never happened. My friend's girlfriend, she said she went to the gynecologist and he was training somebody. She goes, oh, it was so uncomfortable. I'm like, are you sure he was training somebody? You know, it could be just his friend. Hey, you want to go to work? Come on, we'll have some fun. It's a little awkward. If you're a girl, like, and you have your legs up in the air, and then you know the guy doesn't, he's not a doctor. He's like, oh, where babies come out of. Oh, nice. You sure he's a doctor? You ever see a baby? I flew here from Los Angeles, and there was a baby with its mom next to me on the plane. And it was so, it had those fat baby legs. They were so fucking cute. Do you know what I'm talking about? I wanted to say to the mom, look, I'm not crazy, I swear to God, but can I bite your baby's legs? I swear to God, I'm not crazy. I just want to fuck, if I could just bite them, then I would be fine, I think, the rest of the trip. Is there any way? I'm not crazy, I swear to God. I swear. It's like a puppy. You ever see a puppy so cute you want to fucking mush its little face? Its little golden retriever? You're like, I'm gonna fucking, God damn, I can't take it anymore. Why isn't it enough just to pet it? It won't release what I need to release. I'm like, what the fuck? Look at that little fucking puppy. Its little eyes and its puppy breath. Holy shit. Cute. I went to the movie theaters last week and I found out. What if that was my post? We all have that picture. I'm not proud of this, but you ever notice when you look in the mirror, do you have the mirror face you make? My mind is this. It's not a big deal, but I do this. I go. See the difference? Look, let me show you.
Here's natural, here's me.
Like that's gonna make me look better. Like if I walked into a bar like this, girls would go, ugh, that guy's fucking gross. Oh. Hi. Sure. Move my face. So I go to the movie theaters and I realize that I have a sense of humor of a group of 15-year-old kids. Here's what happens. This guy walks in the movie theater a little bit late and he's got two, not late, before the movie started. Let me start the whole joke over. So he walks in with two big popcorns and he's got them like this. And these 15-year-old kids yell out, hey, look at me! I've got two really big popcorns! I thought it was so funny. I really did. I turned to my friends, I go, do you get it? They're like, yeah, we fucking get it, Todd. Like, I don't know, they're trying to make it, yeah, okay. I go, I didn't know if you knew, I thought. And then the guy with the popcorns, I swear to God, he looked at everybody like this. And they all looked at him like, yeah, who gives a shit? I'm like, are you serious? I wanted to defend the guy, go, you assholes. Do you really think this guy fucking said, look, I've got two big popcorns? Don't you think the 15-year-old giggling kid set him up? I don't even want to watch the movie with you, you're so fucking stupid. But instead, I high-fived the kids. So, oh, that was funny. Ever go to someone's house and the bathroom is way too close to where everyone's hanging out? That's just painful. Hey, where's the bathroom? It's right over there. What's that, 10 feet from the dining room table? And the gap between the door and the floor is that wide? They used to have shag carpeting, now they have hardwood floors. If I was a bathroom attendant, I would play the trumpet just to give people noise they need. I'd be like, $5. Ba-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum. There you go, $5. I'm always aware people need noise. When I'm leaving a bathroom, I swear to God, I press the hand dryer as I'm walking out, because I know there's someone in there going, yes, thank God. I don't know why, going to the bathroom is gross, it really is, but I know we all do it. I don't even want people to hear me pee. So I flush the toilet first, and then, once it starts twirling, I'm like, oh, I get nervous. I'm like, I'm out of twirl time, so I turn the shower on, the faucet part. I go, shh, because it makes a lot of noise. And then I used to always think that'll prevent me from looking gross. And then one day I thought, oh my God, what if they think, oh my God, he just shit all over himself, he's taking a shower. Ooh, what type of gross people? You know, late at night when you're watching television, it seems to me a lot of ads come on, they think you have a problem because you're up late. Like, they go, did you have genital herpes? You're like, no, I'm just up late, everything's fine. The guy in the ad, I swear, for genital herpes, goes, you know, with my old medicine for genital herpes, you used to have to take 5-6 pills a day. Who has that kind of time? Are you shitting me? You. You with the diseased crotch. How lazy is this guy? They come up with medicine. Fuck, it ain't sitting around taking pills all day. When they can do it with one pill, then I'll cure this thing. But I'll sit around all day, time to take another pill. I love who they try to appeal to. I love it. They have one that goes, you shouldn't have to pay more just because you have bad credit. I'm like, yes, you should. What idiot sitting home going, yeah, just because every time someone lends me money and I don't fucking pay them back, I should get a discount the next time I want money. No, serious. It's bullshit paying more. I'm addicted to infomercials. I know they're bad, but I watch them for an hour. I can't help it. And then they say, hey, if you buy this, it'll save you time. I'm like, well, I'm watching an hour infomercial. I probably have time, but... They have one for the magic bullet. Have you seen this? They go, you can make chicken salad sandwiches in 10 seconds. First of all, who's that much of in a hurry? Seriously. Who goes, yeah, I'll make you a chicken salad sandwich, it'll take 5 minutes. Fuck it. No, I don't want to stick around. No, can you make it in 10 seconds? No? Well, then what should I do? Well, you're making it. Sit here with my thumb up my ass? No, seriously, I'm going to go home. Oh, that's the worst guess. And then they show you, you can make chicken salad sandwich in 10 seconds. A few cubes of chicken, a cherry tomato, and a little bit of cilantro. Yeah, but I don't have bowls of shit all over my kitchen. You gotta count the time it takes to chop the shit up. It's always in the commercial, a little bit of cilantro, a little bit of wet walnuts, a little bit of marshmallow fuck, and a little bit of, No? The voice animated things, they should not try to make them sound real. When you call like American Airlines, and they go, hi, this is Judy, how can I help you? Don't try to make it sound real, because then I expect something of a real person. One time I said, you just want to talk to an agent? You're like, agent! And the computer, I swear to God, goes, A computer says, That's the dumbest computer in the world. Why would you have a computer go, I'm having a hard time understanding you. Why don't they just have it go, I'm a fucking computer and I'm dumb. And I can't understand you. Agent! Even the dumbest person in the world would know what fucking agent meant. You think there's a dumb person out there, that dumb, a real person, you would go, agent! I don't understand what you want. No, seriously, what do you want? I don't know. I was watching this thing on prostitution. I swear to God this is true. Maybe not. And that is. A lot of the prostitutes said they had kids. They're like, I got kids, I'm a good mom. Can you be a prostitute and a good mom? Like, what do you draw from? What do you say to, I don't suck dick all night so you can get a D in math. Now I have had it. My ass is not a windsock so you can buy Pokemon cards all day. But it's a typical mom. Now have some orange juice. Have some orange. I didn't let a Chinese businessman take a shit on me so I could send you to summer camp, and this is the thanks I get? All right, forgot my next joke. Could you tell by blank stare at my notes? Oh, first time, I don't smoke pot a lot. I don't smoke pot 7 days a week, but 3 or 4 times a month I like to smoke. Some of my friends are like, you still smoke pot? I'm like, yeah, it's fun. And, you know, I don't go to my older friends. Hey, you still drink? Yeah. My 50-year-old, whatever, 50-year-old. Well, 50's not that old. 50. Well, when I was little, 50 was very old. When I was little, I thought 50 was like, oh, I'm 50 years old. Then when you're older, you realize 50's like, hey, I'm in a band. Thursday night we play. Not when you're 10. But when you're 10, you're like, I'm 50. I just shit all over myself because I'm 50 and I'm old and ready to die. First time I ever smoked pot, I went to the mall with my stepbrother. My mom got remarried. I had a stepbrother. I was 30 the first time I smoked pot. And he goes, let's go to the mall and get high. So there's a guy that was walking around the mall with like a plant. And if you weren't high, it probably looked totally normal. If you weren't high, it probably looked like this. Guy walking around like this. Because we were high, my stepbrother goes, look, that guy's hiding from the cops. That's what pot can do. It can turn this into this. You ever know anyone that's really boring at work? I'm sure you do. Well, here's what you should do. The next time they tell you really boring, and you gotta sell it really well. If they're really boring and they tell you a boring story, go, oh my God, I read about that in Who Gives a Fuck magazine. No, seriously. No, serious. Sell it really good. No, I'm not being rude. I'm so, you're getting your stories published. That's so cool. No, I'm serious. Oh my God, you're so cool. What if you're so excited to do that, the next time you go to work, you don't really listen, you know? Someone's like, my wife died over the weekend. Oh my God, I read about that new, oh. She all right? You get nervous? You just said, is she all right, but she's dead. No, I mean, now that she's dead, I should probably shut up. Shut up a little bit. My neighbor stinks. I'm not making this up. He really stinks horribly. And it's not coffee breath. It's like, I think he has a rotting tooth or something. And my girlfriend said I should tell him. But he's a nice guy. I don't want to hurt his feelings. She goes, tell him creatively. What are you going to say creatively? I really don't know what she means. Like, how am I supposed to disguise it? Like, hey, Alan, your lawn looks good. Is your ass backed up? No, serious. No, is it serious? No, I'm not trying to be rude. Is it? No, I thought you had a problem. No. Oh, my God, no. What do you think 50 Tic Tacs would taste like? No. You put them all in your mouth and move them around vigorously right before you talk to me. What would that be like? Oh my God. What's up? I was on an airplane once at band camp, and the lady next to me turns to me. She goes, excuse me, does my breath smell like tacos? I said, I don't know. Do you put cat shit in your tacos? No, seriously, do you? No, serious. Serious. She goes, no. I said, then no. It was the then part that annoyed her.